So for the last 5 weeks, I completed my internal medicine rotation at a correctional facility. During this time, I got to learn firsthand what it takes to deliver quality healthcare to our inmate population. Also, make sure you stick around for the end of this video to hear about all of the skills and procedures that I got to do on this rotation. ¿Qué onda, plebes? My name is Mario Navarro. I'm the Mexican PA, a second-year PA student at UC Davis in Sacramento, California. If you find this type of content interesting, exciting, or helpful, make sure you like, subscribe, and consider dropping a comment down below if you have any questions. I do want to preface with the fact that all of the footage that you'll see in this video is stock footage and footage that I found on news reports or online. Because of the rules of prisons and correctional facilities, I definitely wasn't allowed to record anything. So now we're going to watch some footage from an ABC News documentary of a California correctional facility, and we're going to watch it together because I think it does a really good job of painting exactly the environment that I was in.
We get here right at sunrise. This is when most of the guard staff come in and when the inmates get up.
Usually I'll wake up about 5:30, get up, wash up. They have breakfast.
I'll talk about my schedule in a little
bit. Every day, it's the same routine.
Y'all want breakfast?
In the dining hall, it's actually pretty quick. You go on in there, you get your tray. That's your recreational activity. You can
it
go
looks
out there,
exactly
you can
like
work
this.
Out. You can play handball, they have basketball, you can play tennis.
And so as you saw, it's a very, very unique environment. And that was probably the most unique thing about this rotation was the setting. And I say this because when you go on a rotation site, you're thinking about a lot of things. You're thinking about, you know, do I know the medicine enough to, you know, apply it successfully? And so that I don't look like an idiot in front of my preceptor. Like that's a very real fear that a lot of students, including myself, that we have. And but on top of those thoughts and wanting to do right by your patient, when you're in a correctional facility, you also, at the forefront of your brain, need to maintain the potential security risks that are at hand. So for example, in some situations, my preceptor and I had to deliver care within a cell directly to a patient. And so this required my preceptor and I to position ourselves in a way where we were between the patient and the door. And so if anything were to go down, we could quickly exit the cell and, you know, be in a safe position. So now let's talk about the medicine and what this rotation actually entailed. What does the word internal medicine even mean? So internal medicine is a medical specialty that focuses on the prevention, diagnosis, and treatment of adult diseases. Physicians and PAs who specialize in internal medicine are often called internists or internal medicine specialists. So internists are trained to provide primary care to adult patients and are skilled in managing complex medical problems and chronic diseases, so things like diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, lung disease, and kidney disease. They have expertise in managing multiple medical conditions and coordinating care with other healthcare providers, such as specialists and surgeons. The main role of a PA in a correctional facility is to provide medical care to inmates in a secure environment. So for this rotation, my schedule was Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. on most days. Every day I would drive into the parking lot around 6:45 a.m. I would then start the long walk into the facility with only a few items on my person, such as my ID, a single debit card, a single car key, and my stethoscope, a small lunch bag with no metal silverware, and the most important part, no blue scrubs. So, not this. That's better. So, essentially the reason why I couldn't wear blue scrubs is because the inmate population wears blue. And so in the event of an emergency or, you know, any situation, you definitely don't want to be confused or be looking like the inmates. So after arriving inside the office, I would then hop on a phone call to listen to all of the providers discussing any overnight events or anything that happened over the last shift. So things like patients who, you know, declined clinically or other patients that had to be transferred out via ambulance. After that, I would proceed to start reviewing patient charts and prepare for something called the procedure clinic. Most days I work with two different preceptors, so a PA or a physician. Yeah, but most of the time was spent with the PA. And this PA did everything from diagnosing illnesses, prescribing medications, And the coolest thing by far is that this PA ran the entire procedure clinic. So the way this clinic was set up is that it would run usually Monday through Thursday from 8 a.m. to about 12 noon. And this PA would see patients back to back to back and do procedures on each and every one of them. And because I was working under him, that meant I got to do a lot of procedures. So from least invasive to most interesting and invasive, I got to do things like toenail trimmings, callus removals, cryotherapy for like suspicious tags, corticosteroid shot injections of the shoulder, of the knee, of the finger, many lidocaine injections to numb areas where we were gonna cut or do some other procedure on, full toenail removals, incision and drainage of abscesses, wound care, suturing, suture removals, and my favorite and most invasive procedure by far, paracentesis. So a paracentesis is just a big word that means taking out extra fluid from someone's belly. This excess fluid is called ascites or ascites, I can never say the word, and is commonly seen in people with things like liver disease, cancer, heart failure, or kidney disease. During this procedure, the patient is positioned lying down flat and the skin over the abdomen is cleaned with an antiseptic solution. A local anesthetic is injected to numb the skin and the underlying tissues. And then from there, a needle or catheter, as you're seeing here, is inserted through the abdominal wall into the peritoneal cavity. And the excess fluid is then drained out using a syringe, and that's kind of hooked up to essentially a bottle vacuum, as you see here. So I had the opportunity to do two of these procedures on my own and witness a bunch of others that were done by the other student that was at this clinic. It was dope. Overall, this rotation was definitely not what I expected it to be. I showed up there feeling kind of intimidated that, you know, I was inside a correctional facility. But after being there for 5 weeks, I definitely wish that I was there for just a little bit longer. And I could definitely see myself working in the future with our inmate population. So that's pretty much it for this internal medicine rotation. If you found this content helpful, be sure to like and subscribe. Thank you, plebes, for the support. Animo, and have a great week. We'll be right back.